Hey guys, welcome back to more South Park Encyclopedia. I apologize in advance for any mucusy sounds you might hear because I am still sick. So without further ado, let us start with the Cafeteria Fraiche. Fraiche. So this is basically from the episode called Creme Fraiche, which I think was season 14 or 15's season finale. It's basically about Randy. Well, of course it's about Randy. Basically the story is that Randy wasn't getting satisfied by his wife sexually. You know, they weren't having sex, and so he kind of started obsessively watching the food channel, you know, Food Network, basically jacking off while watching it. You know, it excited him. It was like porn to him. That was a way in which he could release his sexual pent-up energy. Basically, yeah. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. Deglaze that fucking pan. Deglaze the shit out of it and such. But yeah, but then Sharon found out, and basically, you know, she blocked the channels with parent control as though they were porn. And then of course, Randy started cooking on his own, you know, like a cook would, and then he got a job at the school as a cafeteria chef, and that's basically where this idea of his make-believe show called Cafeteria Fraiche came out. Basically, they also wanted to make fun of waiters at restaurants asking if if you wanted cream fraiche on your food. Basically, they thought it was ridiculous, and they wanted to get to that point where basically if someone who watched the episode was asked if they wanted the cream fraiche, they would just burst out laughing, and maybe then they would discourage restaurants from asking about cream fraiche. But yeah, so he d does all this, and basically the boys kind of don't want Randy there anymore, and so basically Cartman dresses up like what's that dude's name? Like Gordon Ramsay, and basically comes in and starts abusing him, and then it all ends with this huge chef cookout, you know, like Jamie Oliver is there, and you know, Paula Deen before she said the N-word, or whatever the fuck she said. Basically, Randy had no cream fraiche, and so he went home looking for cream fraiche, and there it collides with the second storyline. Basically, you know, Sharon was not satisfied, and so she went out to buy work equipment. I mean, fitness equipment, and basically she got the shake weight. If you don't know what a shake weight is, then Google it. It's one of the most goddamn funny things ever. It's basically it's sold as you know, a weight which you have to hold in your hand, and it kind of shakes by itself. And what does that remind you of? Oh yeah, it It reminds you of a hand job. So basically, it's a hand job training machine, which is extremely amusing. Basically, the shaker came with the voice box. Basically, harder, faster, switch hands. And at the end, of course, it released this little cooling spray, which basically represents the splooge after a hand job, of course. So that was pretty fun. And he she does the thing where she goes to find her groove. She takes shake weight with her to a resort, and there basically she finds the what's called ah damn it you know the person at hotels who basically takes your sheets and your pillows and changes them. The room cleaning lady. I have a lapsus about her actual name. So basically, Sharon finds her using the shake weight, and then it's like, oh my God, you betrayed me. But then she comes back home, and Randy's there, and basically, she realizes what shake weight has been trying to tell her, and how to get Randy to stop being obsessed with food. And basically, she takes him upstairs and gives him an old fashioned. Basically, an old fashioned is of course a hand job. And then that became the thing. Basically, they started calling it an old fashioned, and apparently it kind of caught on for some reason. And now apparently some people are calling it an old fashioned. And then basically the shake weight said, like, yes, I am not actually a weight training machine. I am a relationship thing machine. Fuck it. So that's basically it. Calculator. Display reads 531-8008. Oh, so it's actually boobies spelled backwards. That's entertaining, isn't it? Calculators haven't really been featured on the show, so I don't know exactly what to say about it. Canadian adoption papers. These papers are necessary to legally move a child and his or her box of faith out of Canada. Okay, so this touches on a couple of episodes. The adoption papers were actually used in the episode called Christmas in Canada, where basically sorry. Where basically they Trey and Matt were basically hearing about this new prime minister in Canada who was changing all of the rules, and basically they made it so that one rule would be like for all Canadian adopted children to be reintegrated in Canada. And so Kyle, heartbroken about the Ike being taken by his real parents. Basically, he and the others set out to retrieve him, to get the prime minister and basically have this rule changed. And so, oh, and throughout this episode, basically, Carmen keeps saying that if If this mission m makes them miss Christmas at home, then he will beat the shit out of Kyle, which of course is would be quite entertaining. But yeah, so they basically hire Leo Kim, the shitty war guy, to fly them to Canada. However, they crash land, and then it's basically a Wizard of Oz type deal, where basically everybody's singing, and Canada has the only road in Canada. And on the way they meet three guys. Like, for example, they meet a Mountie who who like was also affected by the new Prime Minister's rules, that basically Mounties can't ride horses anymore. They can only ride sheep or something. Then they meet a mime in the French part of Canada, and a new law forbade them to drink wine. And then they basically meet some sort of I know, redneck Canadian, who basically was upset that he couldn't sodomize his sons because of a new law, which is kind of fucked up. But then the ball drops that basically, yeah, they were on the only road in Canada, but they were going on it in the wrong way. So to reach the Prime Minister, they had to go all the way back. But thankfully, the last man had a boat, and so they reached the capital. Basically, it's like just like the Lord of not the Lord of the Rings, just like Wizard of Oz, you get a massive head thing which kills Kenny, of course. I mean, how couldn't it? And then they find out that the man behind the curtain was basically Saddam Hussein. And that came from the fact that basically that same week, earlier that week, they basically found Saddam in that hole in Iraq. So they put that in. And so, because Saddam Hussein was the new prime minister, they realized that the laws he passed were kind of didn't count. And so they took Ike back, the guy could sodomize his sons in peace, the French Canadians could drink their wine and such. Unfortunately, they missed Christmas, and so Carmen was kind of preparing to beat Kyle up, but before he could do anything, basically Kyle like hit him. Like, it wasn't really it was more like a poke. But then Carmen starts balling up like a fucking bitch, and basically they said that they had to draw a whole new face for Carmen like that, because that cry of Carmen is just hilarious. One of the most hilarious things ever. So yeah. Canadian gemstone, I'm not sure. Of course, the vase thing. It refers to the Legend of Zelda thing, where you have to basically break vases to find loot. Canadian treasure, okay. Cardboard roll, nothing. Ceramic shards, nothing. Charm bracelet, also nothing. I don't think it featured in any episodes. Cherokee hair tampon, made from all natural, highly absorbent Cherokee hair. Okay, so this episode was, I think, back in season 3 or 4, and it dealt with the issue of all natural medicine, and how some of it was kind of bullshitty. So the story goes that Kyle had some sort of a disease for which he had to have a transplant. However, someone tips Sheila Broflowski. Someone tips her about a new natural store in South Park, ruled by, I mean, owned by a woman called Misinformation. Hint, hint, funny shit. Basically, Misinformation kind of gives them, like crappy tea which doesn't do anything, and other shit, all natural toothpaste which stands says tastes like ass and doesn't fight tooth decay, which is fun. But yeah. And basically, Kyle keeps getting worse, but Misinformation says he's getting better. And there are also these two guys who she says are Native Americans, but they're actually Mexicans. Or one of them is, at least. And the cool thing is that those two guys were voiced by Cheech and Chong. And how that came to be is basically they wanted Cheech and Chong to do the voices, and they reach out to them separately, and basically they told each of them that yeah, do you want to do it? Because the other guys said he would, and basically then apparently they were totally okay to do it, but neither of them knew that the other one was open to doing it. And so they did, and they liked the thing that inspired them to continue working together, to put out new stuff. But yeah, Kyle keeps getting worse, and then Stan finds out that he needs a liver transplant, no, a kidney transplant, and that the only person in town who Kyle is kind of who shares Kyle's blood type is actually Cartman, and Stan says, "Oh shit." Because of course Cartman won't ever give up a kidney for Kyle, especially for Kyle. And, basically they try to steal his kidney in the night, but thankfully he had this chastity belt thing called Kidney Protector 2000 or something, which is fun, of course. But in the end, they kind of actually know before they find out that misinformation was actually saying the misinformation. They make a push with the Cherokee hair tampons, which basically they say, yeah, Cherokee hair is a very absorbent. You can use it, and it will, it will do shit. All natural Cherokee hair tampons. Basically, they do this live action commercial for these things, which is cool. I'm pretty sad that they kind of renounced doing live action stuff. I mean, okay, they did live action in the episode called "I Never Should Have Gone Ziplining," but for the most part, they didn't do any live action anymore, and it's sad because that shit was funny when it was live action. Basically, it was just like a tampon commercial, only that it starts off with a girl who goes to her mom and "Mom, do you know when you get that feeling down there? Yes, yeah, no. No, mom, you don't get it. It's like the one scene in The Shining where the elevator door is basically open, and yes, I know. You should try all natural Cherokee hair tampons. Basically, they show a tampon, and then they show a woman with hair, who they say is Cherokee, but actually it's one of their friends, and basically, they pour some water on her hair, and they say, yeah, it's very absorbent. Cherokee hair is known to be one of the most absorbent things in all of the world. So yeah, use it. But then, of course, they find out that misinformation was full of crap, and they basic and basically the whole town kind of collaborates to trick Cartman into giving up his kidney. But thankfully, he gave up his crappy kidney because Kyle keeps. When Kyle laughs now, he basically has milk spill out of his nose for some reason, even though he wasn't drinking milk. And basically, Karma had that problem too, but that thing kind of cured him of it. Okay. Well, that's kind of it for today. See you next time, guys. Bye.